India, a nation great, more people made, is celebrating its Republic Day again. Its freedom fighters' sacrifice won't fade. Their struggles, bloodshed was never in vain. Kudos to leaders who have plans galore. Kudos to citizens who love their soils. Kudos to the ones who risk their lives and toil. Kudos to the brave hearts who come to the fore. On the eve of our 72nd Republic Day, I, Sakshi Sagwal of Class 12B, extend my warm greetings to all of you. On the eve of our 72nd Republic Day, we are here to celebrate this occasion on the virtual platform. This year, India celebrates its 72nd Republic Day, commemorating the historic moment when India became an independent republic country, when the Constitution of India came into effect. India is the cradle of human race, the birthplace of human speech, the mother of history, and the grandmother of traditions. The most valuable and the most artistic materials in the history of men are treasured here in India only. So let us think about our past and try to build a better future for all of us. It is the duty of all of us. We are proud to be Indians. Being citizens of an independent republic country, we have freedom in mind, faith in words, pride in our heart, and the most important, patriotism in our souls. So let's salute our nation on its 72nd Republic Day. I would like to say, let us introspect whether we, as responsible citizens of the country, are fulfilling our fundamental duties or we need to work harder in this direction. The values and the ideas have to be worked upon only by the thriving society. This is not at all possible in a dormant society where people do not care for what is happening around them. They do not care or question on anything. So my dear friends, awake, march a step forward and try to build a better future. For every action done today will have its consequences in the future. The pandemic has powered the adoption of e-education or online education technology to establish an adaptive learning system. So we all are here to celebrate an important occasion of 72nd Republic Day. So let's start the celebration.
Greetings to all. 26 January is a red letter day in the history of our country, India. And I'm proud to wish you all on this special day. May you enjoy endless years of freedom. Since ages, India has the greatest cultures in the world. It has witnessed the oldest civilizations and it has given so much to the world. It has been known as the Sone Ki Chidiya due to abundance of wealth and rich heritage and culture. India has given endless contributions to the world. It established the first university in Taxila. It gave the numeral zero to the world. Ayurveda, cure to leprosy, cataract surgery, trigonometric functions, the crescograph, and even the game of chess, and the list goes on. We have every reason to be proud of our country. Then, why do we forget our responsibilities? Due to some such people, we became the slaves of the British. It took ages and sacrifices of millions of people to get our freedom back. We are lucky to breathe in a free country, and it is our first duty to guard this freedom and protect the future of our country. Now, not from foreign invaders, but from inside evils that are spreading like termites. Children, the future is yours. Prepare yourself for a better one, and that will happen only when you start developing self-discipline, self-control, build character, inculcate patriotism, and above all, love for humanity. Stop thinking only of yourself, your family. Instead, start thinking of the whole society. Start thinking what you can do for your country instead of criticizing others. Even small contributions make a difference. Don't think what you will get in return, because you already have the reward of living in a free country. Maintain this freedom and try to build a better place to live. Be proud to be an Indian. Love India, respect India, be the future India. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Good morning, everyone. Today, we all are celebrating our 72nd Republic Day. On this auspicious occasion, I extend my heartiest greetings and good wishes to you all. As you all know, we celebrate Republic Day on 26 January as the Indian Constitution came into force at this day in 1950. Indian Army do Republic Day parade and take salute of the national flag. There is also a big exhibition of the Indian culture and tradition by the different Indian states to show the unity in diversity. At the Red Fort, the national flag is hoisted. This day gives the message of solidarity, equality, and harmony. Being Indian citizens, we all have moral responsibility and duty towards our nation, and we should preserve our country's real meaning, position, culture of humanity, and spirit of brotherhood, and enhance the glory of this occasion. We have to promise today to work hard and rededicate ourselves to build a stronger and developed nation. Once again, I wish you all a very happy Republic Day. Jai Hind.
सुप्रभात, आज गणतंत्र दिवस के पावन पर्व पर मैं आप सभी को हार्दिक बधाई देती हूँ। देशभक्तों के बलिदान और संविधान के सम्मान के प्रति नतमस्तक होते हुए मैं मेहर आज एक कविता प्रस्तुत करने जा रही हूँ। अतीत के पन्नों की जुबानी सुनाती हूँ आज एक मर्म कहानी। होना चाहिए था जिसे सोने की चिड़िया, होना चाहिए था जिसे सोने की चिड़िया, बनी थी वो कागज की गुड़िया। ना केवल विदेशियों ने सताया था उसे, बल्कि अपने भी लोगों ने रुलाया था उसे। फिर भी क्या पांचों उंगलियां होती हैं समान, कुछ निकली गद्दार तो कुछ हुई उस पर कुर्बान। गांधी ने था शुरू किया आजादी का अभियान, मतवालों ने लोहा लिया करके खुद को कुर्बान। राजगुरु भगत सिंह सुखदेव हुए थे ऐसे स्वाभिमानी, अंत समय में भी बात अंग्रेजों की थी ना मानी। ऐसी वीर गाथाओं से बना है भारत का इतिहास, गिनवाते गिनवाते जिनको होगा ना मुझे समय का एहसास। अंत में रंग लाया उन वीरों का बलिदान, जिन्होंने न्योछावर किए इस भूमि पर अपने प्राण। मिला है अवसर हमको आज कर ले उन वीरों का गुणगान, पर एक बात का रखना होगा ध्यान, संविधान का सदा करना होगा सम्मान। तो आओ आओ मिलकर ले ये प्रतिज्ञा, कभी ना करेंगे इसकी अवज्ञा, सदा बढ़ाएंगे संविधान का सम्मान। विश्व में ऊंची करेंगे इसकी शान। धन्यवाद।
Thank you.
Happy Republic Day. I extend my warm greetings to all of you. On 26 January 1950, our Constitution came into effect. Even before that, this date had acquired special significance, having resolved to attain Puran Swaraj. Our country people had been celebrating Puran Swaraj Day on every 26 January from 1930 to 1947. That is why in 1950 we decided to celebrate the same date when India became a republic. The modern Indian state comprises the three organs, legislature, executive and judiciary. These are interlinked and interdependent of each other. Our constitution gave us rights as citizens of a free democratic nation, but also placed on us certain duties also. Justice, liberty, equality and fraternity are the jewels of our constitution. Let us conclude with the words of Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. If we wish to maintain democracy not merely in form but also in fact, what must we do? The first thing, in my judgment, we must do is to hold fast to constitutional methods of achieving our social and economic objectives. At last, I would like to say, Azadi ki kabhi sham na hone denge. Azadi ki kabhi sham na hone denge. Shahidon ki kurbani badnaam na hone denge. Bachi hai jo ek boond lahu ki tab tak. Bachi hai jo ek boond lahu ki tab tak. Bharat maa ka aanchal neelam na hone denge. Aap sabhi ko Ganatantra Divas ki bahut bahut shubhkamnaye. Dhanyavaad.
On the eve of 72nd Republic Day, I extend my warm greetings to everyone. 7 decades ago, on 26th January 1950, our constitution came into effect. The main celebrations are held in New Delhi at Rajpath every year. The event is commemorated with great enthusiasm and patriotism, which shows the unity in diversity and the rich cultural heritage that India has. However, every year we hear the messages of brotherhood, patriotism, unity and integrity. But how many of us really bother to keep our country united? In the act of pursuing our selfish interest, we should not forget our freedom fighters who sacrificed their lives for the motherland and our soldiers who fight on borders to keep us safe from any sort of terrorist attack. We should try to bring a positive change in ourselves. Then only we'll be able to become a better nation and a better place to live in. Thereafter, the celebration would be a real celebration. But this year, the Republic Day is a tribute to the Corona warriors who fought by being in the front line. Irrespective of the danger of the pandemic, we should salute the medical community, including doctors, nurses, and also the security personnel who sacrificed their lives to keep us safe from any risk. Teachers may not be the front line technically, yet they have during these unprecedented times. They took the initiative of continuing with the education which has totally stopped due to the closure of schools. Let us salute them. Let us make a pledge to our motherland that we will do everything to rid it out of all levels. Thank you so much. Jai Hind. Thank you.
रहा संघर्ष की जो चलता है, रहा संघर्ष की जो चलता है, वो ही संसार को बदलता है। जिसने रातों से जंग जीती, जिसने रातों से जंग जीती, सूरज बनकर वही निकलता है, सूरज बनकर वही निकलता है। सुप्रभात, सभी को गणतंत्र दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं। आज मैं आपके समक्ष गणतंत्र दिवस पर कुछ पंक्तियां सुनाना चाहती हूँ। आओ तिरंगा लहराएं, आओ तिरंगा फहराएं, आओ तिरंगा लहराएं, आओ तिरंगा फहराएं, अपना गणतंत्र दिवस है आया, झूमे नाचें खुशी मनाएं, झूमे नाचें खुशी मनाएं। अपना 71वां गणतंत्र दिवस खुशी से मनाएंगे, देश पर कुर्बान हुए शहीदों पर श्रद्धा सुमन चढ़ाएंगे, श्रद्धा सुमन चढ़ाएंगे। 26 जनवरी 1950 को अपना गणतंत्र लागू हुआ था, भारत के पहले राष्ट्रपति डॉक्टर राजेंद्र प्रसाद ने झंडा फहराया था। मुख्य अतिथि के रूप में सुकार्नो को बुलाया था, थे जो इंडोनेशियन राष्ट्रपति, भारत के भी थे हितेशी। था वो ऐतिहासिक पल हमारा, जिससे गौरवान्वित था भारत सारा, जिससे गौरवान्वित था भारत सारा। विश्व के सबसे बड़े संविधान का खिताब हमने पाया है, पूरे विश्व में लोकतंत्र का डंका हमने बजाया है, पूरे विश्व में लोकतंत्र का डंका हमने बजाया है। इसमें बताए नियमों को अपने जीवन में अपनाएं, थाम एक दूसरे का हाथ, आगे आगे कदम बढ़ाएं, आगे आगे कदम बढ़ाएं। आओ तिरंगा लहराएं, आओ तिरंगा फहराएं, अपना गणतंत्र दिवस है आया, झूमे नाचें खुशी मनाएं, झूमे नाचें खुशी मनाएं। धन्यवाद। जय भारत, जय भारत।
Today I'm going to recite a poem on the occasion of Republic Day. Ours is a land of sages, known for bravery for ages. None can with it compete, its culture none can beat. Whatever caste or religion, all live here in unison. With rivers feed fountains, it's a land of high mountains. Its green forests are pretty and are the source of prosperity. So let's for it. So let's for it. Work hard for its safety. Be on guard for its safety.
क्या कहानी है? हमारी पहचान तो बस इतनी है कि हम हिंदुस्तानी हैं, हम हिंदुस्तानी हैं। सुप्रभात, मैं वृंदा, कक्षा 10वीं की छात्रा, आप सभी को गणतंत्र दिवस के उपलक्ष्य में हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं देती हूँ। गणतंत्र दिवस का यह राष्ट्रीय पर्व हमारे लिए बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है, क्योंकि ये वह दिन है जब हमारा देश मानचित्र पर एक गणतांत्रिक देश के रूप में स्थापित हुआ था। लंबे समय तक हमारा भारत देश अंग्रेजों की गुलामी में रहा है, परंतु हजारों लाखों लोगों की कुर्बानी के बाद हमारा देश आजाद हुआ। आजादी हमें भीख में नहीं मिली है। इसके लिए लाला लाजपत राय, भगत सिंह, महात्मा गांधी आदि अनेक स्वतंत्रता सेनानियों ने जान की बाजी लगाई, तब जाके हमें आजादी की सौगात मिली। आजादी के 2.5 साल बाद 26 जनवरी 1950 को हमारा संविधान लागू किया गया। संविधान ने हमारे देश को अखंडता एवं एकता प्रदान करी। इसने हमें हमारे अधिकारों तथा कर्तव्यों से परिचित कराया। संविधान की मजबूती से हमारे भारत देश ने बहुत प्रगति करी है। क्रीड़ा, चिकित्सा, शिक्षा आदि हर एक क्षेत्र में भारत के कदम सफलता की ओर बढ़े हैं। परंतु अफसोस की बात यह है कि आज हम अपने अधिकारों की तो बात करते हैं, परंतु अपने कर्तव्यों को भूल जाते हैं। यदि आज हर एक भारतवासी अपने कर्तव्यों को पूरी ईमानदारी से निभाए, तो भारत की प्रगति में आने वाली हर एक बाधा स्वयं ही मिट जाएगी। इस दिन हमें यह संकल्प लेना चाहिए कि हम अपने कर्तव्यों को पूरी ईमानदारी से निभाएंगे तथा अपने संविधान का सम्मान करेंगे, देश में शांति बनाए रखेंगे। आओ ऐसे कर्म करें, सर्वत्र हो संविधान का सम्मान। भारत भू पर जन्म लेने पर हो हर भारतवासी को अभिमान।